Hello friends, welcome to Biovidyalaya. I hope you all are doing very well. Here in this video, we are going to discuss about one of the important and most requested topic from genetics, that is how to solve probability problems. How to solve probability problems from genetics. So before going to begin, if you didn't subscribe this channel, please do subscribe and also don't forget to enable the bell icon. So let's start. I think you all have studied probability in your plus two classes. Probability means it is simply how likely something is to happen. Whenever we are unsure about the outcome of an event. So, probability is equal to number of times an event occurs divided by total number of events. For example, if you roll one die, one six-sided die once, what is the probability of getting six? That is, number of times an event occurs, that is one, and total number of events, it is a six-sided die, that's why the total number of events is six. So, this is the probability of getting six when we roll one six-sided dice one time. Okay. In genetics, it can be also used to calculate probability of traits in larger population. Okay. In genetics, probability is equal to number of individuals with a given phenotype divided by total number of individuals or number of individuals with a given genotype divided by total number of individuals. Okay. So, here a cross between heterozygous capital T small t into capital T small t. So, what is the probability of getting small t, small t. So, here number of individuals with a given genotype, that is small t is 1. So, 1 divided by total number of individuals. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. Total 4 is there. So, 1 by 4. So, 1 by 4 is the probability of getting small t genotype when we cross heterozygous. Okay. Two useful probability rules used in genetics are product rule and sum rule. First, here we are going to discuss about product rule. Product rule is one of the very important or very useful rule in genetics, and it states that the probability of two or more independent events occurring together can be calculated by multiplying the individual probabilities of the event. So, here the event should be independent events. That means outcome of one event that will not depend on the outcome of another event, that is independent events. In such condition, we are multiplying the individual probabilities of the events. For example, I told you that if you roll a six-sided die once, you have a 1 by 6 chance of getting a 6. Isn't it? If you roll two dice at once, if you roll two dice at once, your chance of getting two sixes. This event is independent event. The outcome of die one is not depending upon the outcome of die two. So, we are using product rule. So, probability of 6 on die 1 into probability of a 6 on die 2. What is the probability of 6 on die 1? That is 1 by 6 into probability of 6 on die 2, that is also 1 by 6. So 1 by 6 into 1 by 6, that is equal to 1 by 36. So 1 by 36 is the probability of getting 2 sixes. If you roll 2 dice at once, your chance of getting 2 sixes is 1 by 36. I will tell another example from genetics. Just imagine a cross between capital A and small a. Mother is capital A, small a, and father is also capital A, small a. So what is the probability of getting small a offspring? For getting small a offspring, small a gamete from mother should combine with small a gamete from father. Then only we will get small a offspring, isn't it? So, what is the probability of getting small a from mother? Small a gamete from mother, that is 1 by 2, 50%. And what is the probability of getting small a gamete from father? That is also 1 by 2. So, probability of getting small a offspring is 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. That is equal to 1 by 4. Okay. Next is sum rule or OR rule. Okay. According to the sum rule, the probability that any of several mutually exclusive events will occur is equal to the sum of the events' individual probabilities. This is the probability of one event or another event occurring. So here the events are mutually exclusive. That means outcome of one event is depending upon the another event. That means both cannot occur at the same time. So here we are using sum rule, sum of the events individual probabilities. Okay. We know that if you roll a six-sided dice, you have a 1 by 6 chance of getting any given number. If you roll one six-sided dice means, what is the probability of getting 5? That is 1 by 6. What is the probability of getting 6? That is also 1 by 6. But you can only get one number per roll. You can get only one number per roll. You could never get both 1 and 6 at the same time. That means these outcomes are mutually exclusive. Okay. So the probability of rolling a 5 or 6 in a single throw of a dice is probability of getting a 1 plus probability of getting a 6. What is the probability of getting 1? That is 1 by 6. Plus, what is the probability of getting 6? That is also 1 by 6. So, 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6 is equal to 1 by 3. Okay. Next, we can discuss one example from genetics. We can take the same example here also. Here, capital A, small a crossing capital A, small a. This is mother and this is father. Here we have to find what is the probability of getting a dominant phenotype. What is the probability of getting a dominant phenotype? Okay.
So dominant phenotype means the genotype should be capital A, capital A, or capital A, small a. Okay. So let's do the cross. Capital A, small a. And capital A, small a. Okay. So we will get capital A, capital A, that is capital A gamete from mother and capital A gamete from father. Here capital A, small a, that means capital A gamete from mother and small a gamete from father. Here capital A, small a, here small a gamete from mother and capital A gamete from father. Here small a, small a, here small a gamete from mother and small a gamete from father. So there are three events. Three events can lead to dominant phenotype. That means two capital A gamete, that is from one from father and one from mother. And next is capital A gamete from mother and small a gamete from father. Okay. Next, small a gamete from mother and capital A gamete from father. Okay. So what is the probability of getting dominant phenotype? So that is probability of getting capital A from mother and capital A from father plus probability of getting capital A from mother and small a from father plus probability of getting small a from mother and capital A from father. Okay. So what is the probability of getting capital A from mother? That is 1 by 2 into what is the probability of getting capital A from father? That is also 1 by 2 plus what is the probability of getting capital A gamete from mother? 1 by 2 into what is the probability of getting small a gamete from father? That is also 1 by 2 plus what is the probability of getting small a gamete from mother? That is 1 by 2 and capital A gamete from father. That is also 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. That is equal to 3 by 4. So probability of getting a dominant phenotype is 3 by 4. I think this is clear for you. In our next video, we will discuss more probability question from genetics.
If you like this video and find it helpful, then please click the like button, share this video with your friends, and your subscription is my motivation to make more videos like this. So don't forget to subscribe this channel and also don't forget to enable the bell icon so you will get notification when I upload new videos. Keep learning. Thank you.